Our text says, removes branches that do not bear fruit. Jesus explains this. He says, if anyone does not abide in me, he is thrown away like a branch and withers. And the branches are gathered, thrown into the fire, and burned. Now remember, this is metaphor. And the fire here is not just a normal fire. This is the fire of judgment. This is hell. And friends, this work of our Father in heaven is frightening to think about, because it appears that these branches are not pagans, of course. Of course, they're not producing fruit because they're not Christian. They're not attached to the vine. These unproducing branches are Christians who have rejected the faith and are no longer abiding in Christ. They no longer believe. They are no longer producing fruit. And sadly, their fate is unquenchable fire. I do not try to understand how it works that someone who has gained life in Christ can consent to the powers of darkness and reject the life that they were given. Do not I try to understand it, because it is the devil's work, you see. Rather, abide in Christ. Believe in him. And by abiding in him, you will produce fruit that the Father sees and is happy. Now, by the way, when branches are bearing fruit, that is, when Christians are abiding in Christ and believing in him and exhibiting good works, all the glory, all the praise, all the blue state fair ribbons goes to whom? Not the branch, not even the vine, but to the vine dresser, God the Father. Our text says, by this my Father is glorified, that you bear much fruit, and so prove to be my disciples. Now, I know many of you like gardening. In fact, I know one of you has been a literal vine dresser. Well, God is into gardening too, but his plants are us. That is, we are his workmanship. And when we bear fruit, all the praise, all the honor goes to the vine dresser. He is content. Now, we bear fruit, we show good works when, our text says, when we abide in Christ. Our text reads again, abide in me and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit by itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Whoever abides in me and I in him, he it is that bears much fruit. Now, this verb, abide, comes up quite a bit in this passage, and that's for a reason. It's because it's an important concept. Now, other translations use the word remain. Our text here uses abide. But what does it mean to abide in Christ? This is critical. We only produce fruit that the Father wants if we are abiding in Christ. To abide in Christ means to believe in him. To abide in Christ means to believe, trust, have faith in him always. And since the chief business of faith is to receive from Jesus Christ, abiding in him means ever receiving grace upon grace, day by day, Sunday by Sunday, through the word and through the sacraments. Now, if you are worried whether you are abiding in Christ, first check to make sure you are baptized, right? Then check if you are confessing your sins and receiving God's forgiveness and absolution in the divine service, or as we did this morning. Then check to see if you're receiving his body and blood in communion. Check to receive if you're receiving his word as it is preached. Abiding in Christ means believing in him, and that means receiving from him through his word and through his sacraments. So, if that's the case, where does this leave good works, love, joy, peace, patience, hope, endurance. Can I believe, come to church on Sunday, receive the sacrament, and then live like a scallion from Monday through Saturday? The short answer is no. You can't. You cannot. Let's not forget that good works are necessary because God commands them. They don't save us, not at all. Don't trust in your good works to save you, please. We are only saved through faith in Christ. And this is how one of my favorite hymns puts it. Hymn 555 in our hymnal. Faith clings to Jesus' cross alone and rests in him unceasing. And by its fruits, true faith is known, with love and hope increasing. For faith alone can justify. Works serve our neighbor and supply the proof that faith is living. True faith and good works, you see, always go together. They always do. You will not find one without the other. Show me someone with true faith, and I will show you someone with good works. But it starts with faith. Where there is faith, good works are sure to follow, because just as the Holy Spirit gives someone faith and they believe and they're saved, God, the Holy Spirit, also begins to form new impulses in that person, and good works are sure to follow. Now, what if you realize then that you haven't been so loving or joyful or patient? Rather, what if you have found yourself as being hateful or bitter or anxious or impatient? In other words, what if you realize that there's fruit missing from your life? And if we're honest with ourselves, we should notice missing fruit because we sin all the time. Well, don't do this. Muster up all your energy and just make that fruit come off. No. Rather, ask for God's forgiveness. Receive his absolution. Know that your sins are forgiven. Ask the Holy Spirit to strengthen you and to produce that fruit, and guess what? It will come. The fruit will come. Because God promises as much. He says, if you abide in me, and my words abide in you, ask whatever you wish, and it will be done for you. God promises his Holy Spirit to anyone who asks, and if that is the case, then just wait and watch, and look at the fruit come. Friends, woe to the church that does not preach Christ crucified. Now, it's nice to know 5 ways to protect your marriage. It's nice to know 10 ways to keep your financial life healthy. It's nice to know how one can serve their community. But you can have a nice marriage, a nice bank account, and a nice community, and not have Christ, and be lost and condemned. Because you see, the risen and crucified Christ is the only source for eternal life, and Jesus Christ. This is the good news that all need to know and understand. Have peace then in your heart. But you aren't the source for what God is looking for, that good fruit. Jesus is. Believe in him. Confess your sins. Receive his forgiveness. And know in your heart that he has given you his Holy Spirit, who is working in you to produce that fruit. Because you see, Jesus is the vine, and we are the branches.